Chapter 1282, Easily Passing Qualification. In the group stage, because the masters were seated into different groups, Lin Ming was victorious all the way to 10 wins without a single hiccup. Dragon Fang also had a 10-win winning streak. Not just that, but Hang Kai and two other MP Rin direct disciples easily obtained a 10-win winning streak. Although these were group matches, one could see many things. There were always interested parties that soon summarized the top 50 people of all the divisions. Lin Ming and Dragon Fang were arranged within these rankings. The 30 MP Rin direct disciples were naturally included too, as there wasn't a weak MP Rin direct disciple. After all, the weak did not possess the qualifications to become MP Rin descendants. Another matter worth mentioning was Divine Dream Heavenly Palace. Besides the Heavenly Palace Sanus, Fairy Frost Dream, there were also three core disciples. None of these core disciples were weak, and they were all placed into this list of 50 names. The three of them were collectively referred to as the three fairies of the Divine Dream. Their names were Frost Charm, Frost Cloud, and Frost Moon. In Divine Dream Heavenly Palace, all disciples of Frost Dream's generation had a surname Frost, but only the top disciple had qualifications to be called Dream. This was where Frost Dream's name originated from. Divine Dream Heavenly Palace is truly formidable. In the group that the three fairies were located in, Lin Ming silently watched them fight. The one on the arena stage was Frost Moon. She simply stared at her opponent, and without a single move, victory and defeat had already been decided. Her opponent slumped to his knees, all strength fleeing his body. And this person was a second-rank genius from the semi-finals area. A genius that was ranked second out of 100 great worlds actually had no ability to resist in front of Frost Moon. Frost Moon wins. The world king managing this arena area announced without expression. This result was something he already expected. Although the three fairies were formidable, there were actually very few that forfeited when they fought them. This was because as disciples of Divine Dream Heavenly Palace, their statuses were special. They were mysterious and mystical, the definition of perfection. Even if the other geniuses knew they couldn't defeat them, they still fought. At least, when they left the first martial meeting, they would be able to boast that they fought with the fairies of Divine Dream Heavenly Palace. Even if they were horribly defeated, they could still speak with pride about this. Losing to one of the fairies from Divine Dream Heavenly Palace was not a shameful matter. Rather, it was something to show off to others. Divine Dream Heavenly Palace is truly a strange and mystical influence. The other Heavenly Palaces often have trillions of disciples. But Divine Dream Heavenly Palace only has several hundred. Each one of them must be an outstanding individual amongst all outstanding elites, Lin Ming thought. But at this time, a voice suddenly echoed out in his mind. He was startled and then happily said, "Nismo, you've finished your seclusion?" Within the magic cube space, even an Empyrean didn't have the ability to sense Mo Eversnow. Of course, it wouldn't matter even if they did. "I've also realized something from that incomplete bone shard. I've been verifying it with the Celestial Tyrant Manual, one truth at a time, and now I've understood things that I didn't before. The Celestial Tyrant Manual's 100-layered waves can go another step further. How is Fishy?" Lin Ming hadn't looked into the magic cube space for some time now, and Mo Eversnow and Fishy had lived inside as they pleased. Fishy has been sleeping more and more these days. Although she has eaten up a great number of violet sun crystals, there still hasn't been any change within her body. Mo Eversnow shook her head. She guessed that Fishy had some special background and was certainly unique in some way, but up until now she still hadn't seen just how this specialness manifested within Fishy's body. Moreover, Fishy's growth was much slower than that of other little girls. Through these years, she still retained the appearance of an 11-12-year-old little girl. Of the 50 people, besides the three fairies of the Divine Dream Heavenly Palace, another person also caught Lin Ming's attention. He called himself June Blue Moon and he was dressed all in white. From his head to his toes, he emitted the aura of a sad and melancholic scholar. A pot of wine hung from his waist and he used a long sword. What was strange was that this sword seemed rusty. From all appearances it looked like a common mortal sword that was stained with blood and rust. This weapon is. As Lin Ming saw this sword, he felt something indescribable in his heart. This was absolutely not an ordinary sword. The sword blade emitted a light pressure and Lin Ming still wasn't able to see what rank weapon it was. He wasn't able to judge whether it was a spirit artifact or not. This is. Lin Ming deeply looked at that sword. If it was truly an unrivaled treasure sword, why would it be rusted? Those were clearly true rust stains that covered the blade and not some deliberate camouflage. I also cannot see the mysteries behind that sword. Mo Eversnow said from within the magic cube, shaking her head. She could not see through that weapon at all. It could be June Blue Moon's lucky chance, just like your magic cube. Maybe. Lin Ming sighed. In the 3,000 great worlds of the Divine Realm and the quadrillion trillion lives that existed within it, there were bound to be far too many people that came across a heaven-defying lucky chance. There was the dual body and energy cultivator Shiku, Dragon Fang with his three lives pupils, and now this June Blue Moon. All of these people unveiled an unfathomable feeling. Time passed quickly. It was the second day, with evening soon approaching. At this point, the continuous battles had gone on for 2 days and one night. Some matches were extremely bitter and intense, and some matches revealed an absolute disparity in strength. At his final 15th match, Lin Ming finally met an opponent that fought him with everything they had. This person came from Vast Universe Heavenly Palace. "You are strong, but I won't give up just because of this. I want to know just how you climbed up the Divine Seal Altar." As a disciple of Vast Universe Heavenly Palace, the Divine Seal Altar was a legend to them. And The one who broke this legend was not a disciple of their vast universe heavenly palace, but Lin Ming. This caused some disciples to be unable to let this go. They hoped to fight Lin Ming to confirm just what sort of strength he had. As soon as this martial artist faced Lin Ming, his entire body shook as his joints crackled and popped. He stayed at Palace 72 and out of the 14 matches so far, he had only lost a single one, which was against the disciple from Mount Boda, Hang Kai. This was also a reasonable defeat. Hang Kai was an Emperor descendant. Moreover, he came from the heavenly palace with the deepest background in the entire divine realm. It was simply impossible for this martial artist to defeat him. Take my move, Savage Dragon Crossing the River. As soon as this martial artist attacked, it was with his ultimate final killing blow. His saber came slashing towards Lin Ming with overwhelming momentum. In that moment, all of the space around Lin Ming seemed to be locked in place. This vast universe heavenly palace disciple actually used the concept of space. Moreover, his attainments weren't low, he had steadily entered into the fourth level concept. Blue Lotus Flame Dance. Without expression, Lin Ming swept his spear out. The fire laws fused together and a wild and savage spear light gathered into a shimmering beam that instantly broke through his opponent's saber light. Compared to Lin Ming, the difference was simply too great. With the suppression of laws and also absolute strength, there was no way for him to resist. What? The vast universe heavenly palace disciple stared with wide eyes. Even though he knew he wasn't Lin Ming's match, it was only now when he faced him that he discovered how great the disparity was. Whoosh! Lin Ming shot out a second spear strike. This spear strike ripped open his opponent's protective true essence and sent him flying backwards. Lin Ming, victory. The World King Powerhouse managing this arena said without any surprise. Thus, with this, Lin Ming won 15 matches and successfully passed the pre-finals. Lin Ming had now entered the true finals.